The action button on iPhone can do a lot. What about the Apple Watch Ultra? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you 8 use cases for shortcuts on the Apple Watch Ultra, including using it as a garage door opener, automatically texting your ETA to someone, log health data, send pre-made messages to your HomePods via intercom, and even use ChatGPT right here on the watch. So first up, whenever you create a new shortcut, if you want it available on Apple Watch, tap the eye icon at the bottom of the screen, and then toggle on the Show on Apple Watch. Now, not every shortcut or action is going to run on the Apple Watch, but these 8 shortcuts I'm going to show you right now, I've confirmed all work. Also, if you want to see all the shortcuts that are available on your Apple Watch right now, swipe left to see all your shortcuts folders, and you'll see Apple Watch is its own category. So first up is using your Apple Watch as a garage door opener. I'll actually show you how to create it from scratch. We're going to hit the plus button, and we're going to start with an if statement, because we want this to be a toggle, not just controlling it one way or the other. When I tap the first part of that if statement, I can select a home accessory, including my garage. I'll choose my garage door opener, which is a Maris garage door opener. It works with lots of different garage door engines. I'll actually put a link right here to my whole smart home tour where I go through all the smart home devices I have. I'm gonna tap where it says target door state, and I want the current door state. I'm gonna select is, and if it is closed, then we're gonna search for our home control action. You'll see the name of your home right here, and then I'm going to select my garage. And if it is closed, then I want it to open. We'll hit done. I'm gonna drag that action right underneath the if statement, and then I'm gonna tap on that left side and duplicate it, because in the otherwise section, I want the garage door to close. So you'll see if the garage door is closed, then set the garage to open. Otherwise, and this will be the toggle, it will close the garage. That's the whole shortcut. We can name this something unique, hit the I button to make sure the Show on Apple Watch is toggled on. And now when I run this shortcut from the Apple Watch, it will toggle the garage door open and closed right from the watch. And I can do it as soon as I lift my wrist. And because we did an if statement and it checks the garage door state, I can close it or open it just with a tap of the single action button. All right, next up is a home ETA shortcut. I like doing this. Maybe you're coming home from work or just from errands. I have my home address typically listed here. This is not my home address. This is a Cali, great restaurant. And I've shown this kind of shortcut before where it gets the driving time from your current location to that specific address. I set a variable and then a text block. This is gonna be the message I send to someone. It'll say be home in a certain amount of minutes. And then the last part of the message is send that text to a significant other or friend or whoever. You'll be able to download this shortcut in the video description, but I can run that shortcut right on my watch. And so if I do the home ETA, it's gonna get my current location, calculate the travel time to my home address or whatever address you program in the shortcut. That's who it's sending the text to. There's the message, be home in 28 minutes. And then you can choose send this message. You can program this to the action button. This way it does it just on one click. And if you just wanted to send the message, no confirmation needed, just expand this bottom action and uncheck the show and run option. Then it will send without you even having to confirm anything. Number 3 is using Federico Vittici's SGPT shortcut to actually run ChatGPT on the Apple Watch. I'm gonna take a second to show you how to program a shortcut to the action button, and this way you can see it in action, pun intended. If I go to settings, I can go down to action button, and then you can see all the different pre-programmed actions like workout, stopwatch, but shortcut is an option right there. And then you can choose what shortcut you wanna run. I'm gonna choose the SGPT shortcut. And now when I press the action button, it's gonna run that shortcut. What's the average rainfall in the Amazon basin? It's using the ChatGPT APIs, but here you go. This is the ChatGPT answer. So I can ask ChatGPT anything I want right on my wrist. Seems like it might obfuscate the need for some of those other AI gadgets. But anyway, all right, number 4 is getting your home status. I like this kind of shortcut, especially running it at the end of the day. If you have lots of contact sensors, locks, and your garage door, this shortcut gets the status of each of those accessories. That uses the Get Home Status action. Then I have a little text block here, which tells me the accessory name and the current state, and then just shows it on the watch. So if you want to know what's locked and what doors are closed, I can run this home status. Again, you can program this to run when you click the action button. And this will tell me garage is closed, my utility room door is closed, patio door is locked. And you can put any accessories you'd like in here. You can ask if lights are on or off, whether or not there's a water leak in a room, and more. Love the home status shortcut. All right, number 5, this is my intercom options menu. While you can just ask you know who to intercom a certain room, a lot of times it's just not accurate, doesn't hear you well. So I like pre-programming a bunch of things. These are intercoms that I usually send my kids in the various rooms. This is just a choose with menu at the very top. And under each menu option, I have what I want, you know who to say, and to what room. So you can program what room it's gonna go to and what it says. I also have an option for a custom message where I can type a message and then choose the room I want it to go to. This is another choose with menu. Let me add an item here, and I'm gonna choose the studio. I'll duplicate the intercom action, which is a built-in action in Shortcuts, really handy. And I'm gonna intercom that custom text. And when I tap the room name there, I can choose any of the rooms in my smart home. Now, when I run this shortcut on my watch, it'll show me a menu. These are all the intercom options that I pre-programmed. I have one pre-programmed for I'm making a video. This is gonna play here on my HomePod Studios, and you should hear it. Let me tap it.
I'm making a video.
And there played my pre-programmed message in my studio. Now I can also do my custom intercom message. And here I can type something like, hey, we have to go. I hit done, and then it will let me choose the room that I want to send this message to. And I can send it here to the studio again.
Hey, we have to go.
Convenient way to send messages to your HomePods via intercom without having to speak or worry that it heard you right. All right, next up is logging health data. There's actually lots of different data points you can log with your Apple Watch. But I start with a menu right here. It's going to either log the weight or if I brushed my teeth today. To do that, you can create a shortcut with a menu for any data points you would like. And then the action you're looking for is log health sample. When you do log health sample, you can tap the type. And these are all the different data points in the health app that you can program. Not all of them work directly on Apple Watch. You'll have to do some trial and error. But if there's something you're keeping track of, like mindfulness minutes, this is a great way to log that health data right from the action button on your Apple Watch. Now I have a bit of a complicated one for the watch program, but number 7 before we do that is just simply running a HomeKit scene. You can add a HomeKit scene in a shortcut. Here I have my set goodnight scene, and then I can just hit the action button and it runs my goodnight scene. It's pretty simple, but actually plays into the next shortcut and our final one, which is a more serious programming. Now this actually does run on Apple Watch and is responsive. What I have it doing here is it checks my current focus status, and depending on what focus I'm in, will perform a different action. So I have get current focus at the very top. Then I have an if statement as the second step. You do have to adjust this if statement. When you first add an if statement, it's gonna be on the focus side. You actually want to change that to name. So you can do that just by tapping here in the if statement and select name because you want it to run an action based on the name of the shortcut. And so here I have, if my focus mode is sleep, which typically activates around 45 minutes before my bedtime that I have set in the health app, it's gonna set my good night scene. So I don't even have to think about it. I can just hit the action button when it's nighttime and it's gonna set my good night scene. And for the otherwise section, I'm actually gonna leave it blank because it kind of messes up all the other if statements. If there's an otherwise there, the action will most likely just stop. So one if statement, if it's sleep, set the good night scene. On second if statement, I do if my focus mode is filming, which I'm actually in right now. I can double check that by swiping down and that little TV icon and here in the control center both shows me that I'm in my filming focus mode. I can set a different action for when I'm filming. Now I can even choose to run a different shortcut on the Apple Watch. So I'm gonna choose the run shortcut action and let's choose my intercom action. And just for the sake of kind of showing you how this works, I'm gonna go for the intercom action. I'm gonna clear this part because I wanna type something custom. So I'm gonna change this around and say, when I'm in my filming focus mode, just so you can see it on the watch, it's gonna show me a text, just plain old text, that yeah, you're filming. So on the watch, sometimes these shortcuts take a moment to sync back and forth. I'm gonna hit done on the phone. Let me go back into the shortcuts app on my Apple Watch. I'll go to see all, and now let's run the watch program shortcut. I'm gonna set this to the action button, and you can also do this with the watch app on your iPhone. So go to the watch app, action button, and for the shortcut, I can choose my watch program shortcut. And there you go. It says, yeah, you're filming because I'm in my filming focus mode. If in my sleep focus mode, then it's gonna turn off. So if I'm in my sleep focus mode, it's gonna set my good night scene. And you can add as many if statements as you would like to that shortcut. So you can have the action button on your Apple Watch do something different for every focus mode that you have set. And then you can choose when focus mode is off or no focus mode set, have the action button default to something else like SGPT or something you use all the time. So those are 8 shortcuts that run with the action button on Apple Watch Ultra. If you have any ideas or questions to shortcuts you would like to run on the Apple Watch, leave a comment below this video, hit that like button, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Actually, I have an entire playlist on shortcuts for your iPhone and Apple Watch. I'll put that playlist right up here. You know, just binge all those. It also starts with a Shortcuts 101 with 7 easy shortcuts to build, so I recommend checking it out. And if you want to learn more about smart home and home automation, I have a ton of videos on that. You can check out my entire smart home tour for 2024. Had some updates there and new devices. I'll leave that video in the description and up here as well. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.